The last 2 years I spent in trying to understand the problem of schizophrenia, and there are many problems in schizophrenia, I was fascinated by the possibility, by two things. First of all, schizophrenia appears in puberty, but is associated with a dilation of the ventricles, which does not progress with the disease, which means that there is something that happens early on that is important, but not sufficient. One of the objective symptoms of schizophrenia is the incapability of gating. A schizophrenic presented with two sounds very close one to the other one cannot suppress the electrical component that you can recall from the scalp like you and I can. This defect is also present in relatives that are not schizophrenic. There must be something occurring in the neurodevelopmental processes that is common to a family. It's necessary but not sufficient for the disease. And I went to look in possibilities and came out a paper by Curran that they had discovered the Rillin. There is a model for neurodevelopmental studies that was the Rillin mouse that was studied, and everybody agreed that there was a molecule that told the making of the brain. The brain is the biggest machine, the most complicated machine created in the universe. And it's not simple, the creation, but can give us some ideas about the disorders. The disorders do not have very absence of a part of the brain. These are not the disorders you go after, but very subtle disorders. For instance, brain circuitry in the brain is created by the positioning of the neurons. If the position is wrong, the circuitry is different. And now, neurons migrate from the ventricular membrane to the upper part of the cortex. And there is first a group of neurons that migrate first, that are the pioneer neurons. And these neurons are those that are making rally. My ideas about the developmental disorder of schizophrenia, and with some data of the literature indicating that one of the few characteristics of the anatomy of the schizophrenic brain was brought up by the group with Dr. Jones and Biff Bunny in Irvine, was that neurons accumulate in the white matter immediately underneath the end of the cortex. This, to me, this was an indication that there was a defect in migration. And we have developed a quantitative method to measure the messenger RNA for Rellin. And the big discovery was that Rellin was present in the human brain, and the adult brain, rat and human. And the other big discovery was that schizophrenia so far have 50% of the RNA. So in a way, one can look at the schizophrenic brain like the heterozygote of a null mutation in the RNA, which will have 50%. And this will be my most important research for as long as God gives me health and the possibility to do. I think that I want to put in the record that I had one of the most happy lives, because the research gives you really a satisfaction and keeps you always interested in your life and in what happens around you. I want to also say that this happiness was the fact that I had 320 people during my life that joined my laboratory. And this is the stimulus, the most important stimulus. Two stimulus, Brody and the young people around me, made me a very happy person, and I take this occasion to thank both Brody that now doesn't exist anymore and the people that joined me throughout the years. I got my first grant when I was 72 years of age, and I discovered that to work for a grant is very, very interesting. This process of creating a grant from nothing is a very exciting process, because forces you to study. I went to study psychiatry, I went to study psychology, I went to study neurodevelopmental biology in order to put together, because the job that I had is to integrate people. I believe firmly that in neuroscience, program projects have a determining factor in doing what the director of NIMH now calls translational research. Translational research cannot be done if you don't have a group of different skills. The major change is how to do the pharmacology of the gene expression. Right now we are doing it from the receptor. Through my life I learned, first I thought that the brain function was regulated by transmitters, and I discovered that no transmitter regulates any particular function. At the most they can speed up or slow down the rate of firing, but not behavior. Then I thought there were receptors, but one receptor does many other things than the one that you want him to do. And this has an impact in research, because if you analyze the schizophrenic research, has gone first to produce drugs that were more and more specific for a receptor. Now, the ones that are successful are those that are hitting three or four receptors together, which tell us two stories. Dopamine is important, but is not in a part of the etiopathology of schizophrenia, but is a triggering point that we can use in this indirect way to handle the regulation of brain disease. I believe that the gene therapy and the recognition of gene receptors for proteins made by genes would be the next big step.